The golden curtains drew back far enough to make an opening through which marched the captain with the others. The broad, long room they entered was decorated in gold with stained glass windows of splendid colors. In the corner of the room, upon a richly carved golden throne, sat the Fox King, surrounded by a group of other foxes, all of whom wore great spectacles over their eyes, making them look solemn and important. Dorothy knew the king at once, because she had seen his head carved on the arch and over the doorway of the palace. Having met with several other kings in her travels, she knew what to do, and at once made a low bow before the throne. The shaggy man bowed, too, and Button-Bright bobbed his head and said, "Hello."
"Most wise and noble Potentate of Foxville," said the captain, addressing the king in a pompous voice, "I humbly beg to report that I found these strangers on the road leading to your Foxy Majesty's dominions, and have therefore brought them before you, as is my duty."
"So, so," said the king, looking at them keenly. "What brought you here, strangers?"
"Our legs, may it please your royal hairiness," replied the shaggy man.
"What is your business here?" was the next question.
"To get away as soon as possible," said the shaggy man.
The king didn't know about the magnet, of course, but it made him love the shaggy man at once.
"Do just as you please about going away," he said, "but I'd like to show you the sights of my city and to entertain your party while you are here. We feel highly honored to have little Dorothy with us, I assure you, and we appreciate her kindness in making us a visit. For whatever country Dorothy visits is sure to become famous."
This speech greatly surprised the little girl, who asked, "How did your majesty know my name?"
"Why, everybody knows you, my dear," said the Fox King. "Don't you realize that? You are quite an important personage since Princess Ozma of Oz made you her friend."